Topic: Diplomacy. Definitions of diplomacy. Diplomacy is the management of IR through negotiations or the method by which these relations are adjusted or managed. Diplomacy tries to achieve the maximum objectives, national interests, with a minimum of costs in a system of politics where war remains a possibility. There are two major forms of diplomacy. The simplest and the oldest is bilateral diplomacy between two states. Bilateral diplomacy is still common with many treaties between two states. The other form of diplomacy is multilateral diplomacy involving many states. Formal multilateral diplomacy is normally dated to the Congress of Vienna in the 19th century. Since then, multilateralism has grown in importance. Today, most trade treaties, such as the World Trade Organization, arms control agreements, such as the Partial Test Ban Treaty and the Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty, and environmental agreements, such as the Kyoto Accord, are multilateral. The United Nations is the most important institution of multilateral diplomacy. Diplomacy from a historical perspective. The ability to practice diplomacy is one of the defining elements of a state, and diplomacy has been practiced since the first city-states were formed millennia ago. For the majority of human history, diplomats were sent only for specific negotiations and would return immediately after their mission concluded. Diplomats were usually relatives of the ruling family or a very high rank in order to give them legitimacy when they sought to negotiate with the other state. Envoys eventually became negotiators rather than being just messengers. During the Middle Ages, 6th to 18th century, the scope of diplomacy did not grow much and diplomats were mostly confined to maintaining archives rather than negotiating them. In the late Middle Ages, in Genoa, the Duke of Milan established the first foreign mission. After the American and French revolutions, diplomacy became more democratic and less aristocratic. The Congress of Vienna, 1815, laid down procedures for diplomatic immunities and defined diplomatic hierarchies. How diplomacy functions. Diplomacy functions through a network of foreign officers, embassies, consulates, and special missions operating around the globe. Diplomacy is bilateral in character, but as a result of growing international and regional organizations, it is becoming increasingly multilateral in character. What's the difference? Diplomacy and foreign policy. Diplomacy is the method and process by which foreign policy is pursued, but it is not a policy unto itself. The outcome of diplomatic negotiations can affect foreign policy options. Traditional versus modern diplomacy. Traditional diplomacy assumed that major European powers had special responsibility for maintaining world peace and the colonies had no more significant diplomatic role than that of satellites. Modern diplomacy is more open and democratic. It requires reciprocal bargains and compromises, so it is not possible for diplomats to spell out a given stance in advance. Multilateralism is increasingly evident in the practice of modern diplomacy. It includes conference or summit diplomacy, with behind-the-scenes preparations by diplomatic officials. Instruments of diplomacy. Most nation-states maintain state departments of foreign affairs or a ministry of foreign affairs. Foreign office officials include career diplomats and political diplomats appointed by home governments. Ambassadors head foreign missions and serve as the personal representative of the home state in the host country. Counselors of embassies rank second to the ambassador and are career diplomats. Secretaries, with first, second, and third rankings, are mid-career officials implementing foreign policies of their home countries. Attaches are junior career or non-career personnel focusing on specific areas. The presentation of credentials and assuming charge in the host country involves interaction with host governments. Diplomatic missions and personnel enjoy certain immunities and privileges. Home states can dismiss diplomats or they can be declared persona non grata by host countries, due to different reasons, including rising tensions between the two states in question. Functions of diplomacy. Diplomatic functions include reporting socio-cultural, economic, and political conditions of the host country to the home country for formulating diplomatic strategies and formulating foreign policies. Negotiating includes the transmission of messages between foreign ministries of host and home states and the pursuit of agreements by compromise and direct contact. Diplomatic prerequisites. It is necessary that foreign policy objectives must be defined in terms of national interest and supported by adequate power, to enable diplomats to negotiate effectively. Diplomats must be able to realize the objectives and interests of other nations as well. Nations must be willing to show flexibility on issues not vital to them. Diplomatic recognition is perhaps the most important factor in determining whether a nation is an independent state. Receiving recognition has long been difficult, even for countries that are fully sovereign.